So today we are going to see the analysis of pre-stressed concrete beam, okay, by using stress concept, strength concept and load balancing concept. Already you people aware about these three concepts, okay? So this is problem, a pre-stressed concrete beam 400 by 600 mm in section has a span of 6 meters. The beam is pre-stressed with tendon bent as shown in figure below. The external load on the beam consists of a concentrated load of 160 kN, so concentrated load 160 kN at mid span. If the effective pre-stressing force is 1000 kN, effective pre-stressing force this 1000 kN, calculate the extreme stresses for the mid span section by using stress, strength and load balancing concept. Earlier we have dealt with the problems where they have asked only to calculate the stresses by using strength concept or the load balancing concept. But here we are going to solve today problem where same problem we have to solve by using three concepts. Okay, so this is figure they have given. Loading they have given 7 kN per meter, concentrated load, point load 160 kN. Okay, eccentricity at center 150 mm and pre-stressing force is of 1000 kN. This is cross section of beam 400 by 600. We have to calculate the stresses at mid section. Okay, mid span section. Ita aplyala cross section la top stresses and bottom stresses we have to calculate. As usual procedure, we have to calculate the area. So 400 by 600. So this is area of cross section area of the beam. Section modulus BD square by 6. 400 by 600 square divided by 6. So 2.4 into 10 to 7. This is section modulus. First, we are going to solve the problem by using stress concept. So in stress concept, simply we have to take the dead load first. So dead load, point width of beam 0.4 into 0.6 into density of that material. So 6 kN per meter is dead load. So external bending moment, due to that point load WL by 4 and due to UDL WL square by 8. Okay, so point load 160 they have given, so this is length and 4 plus the dead load here 7 into 6 square by 8. So here instead of 6 7 you can put that value as a 6. So 7 into 6 square divided by 8, so 271.5 kN meter. Okay, and after getting that moment value, just we have to put that value into the formulas. Okay, P by A minus plus P into E by Z. So this P into E by Z this is due to the eccentricity, okay, at center. So M by Z is a moment. Okay, so P by A, pre-stressing force 1000 kN, area pre-stressing force into eccentricity 150 and then section modulus and moment which we have calculated to 71.5 into 10 to 6. We have converted, taken this in the Newton and mm. Okay, so next thing here, after getting this total values, direct stress 4.16 minus plus because tension will be at top, compression at bottom. So that value is 6.25. Again here, bending moment top at positive and bottom negative. So that value is 11.31. Okay. And by adding these all at top, stress at top will be 9.22 Newton per mm square. And stress at bottom will be 0.9 Newton per mm square, minus 0.9 Newton per mm square. So this is how we have calculated the stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam. Okay, the main thing here, why we have taken here negative at top, positive at bottom, here positive at top, negative at bottom, because already I have explained you people when we have seen the stress concept, if this is beam and when loading is going to act UDL, beam is going to bend like this. So obviously at top of beam there is a compression and at bottom of the beam there is a tension. So here when we are going to deal with the bending moment, here we are taking compression at top, positive, and tension at bottom. And when with eccentricity, we are going to consider if this is beam subjected with the tendon having some eccentricity. So if this tendon is having some eccentricity with the central axis, due to this eccentricity and this due to this page pressing force, the beam is going to bend like this. Okay, and if beam is going to bend like this, here compression is at bottom and tension will be at top. So that's why here we are consider this is minus sign at top when we are considering the eccentricity and compression at bottom. Okay, so this how we have got the stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam by considering stress concept. Okay, got it. Next concept is the strength concept. We have seen C line, P line in last lecture. So first we are going to calculate shift of C line from P line. So for that, you people know we are going to use formula M by P, that is moment and pre-stressing force. So moment already we have calculated 271.5 into 10^6 in Newton mm, and pre-stressing force in Newton. So that shift of C line from P line, that distance here 271.5 mm. Okay, and how we are going to, now we have to calculate the eccentricity now. So eccentricity of C line we have to consider. So eccentricity of C line will be 271.5 minus 150 is the eccentricity given. So that total value is 121.5. Okay, I will tell you how they have considered the, how they have calculated the eccentricity of C line. If this is beam, okay, and this is central axis. First, we have the P line. P line already you people know. P line is a tendon line, okay? Tendon line. They have calculated first M by P, okay? 271 is shift of C line from P line. So this is P line. Now you, this is 150 distance, eccentricity of P line, and distance which we have got is 271.5. So obviously C line will be here somewhere. This is C line. So distance between C line and P line we have calculated 271.5. Okay, now which thing you required? We required eccentricity of C line. So eccentricity of C lines means that distance always we are going to measure from central axis. So from central axis this distance we have to calculate. Now we know total distance here 271.5, and shift that eccentricity here, this is 150 and this is 271.5. We want eccentricity E dash. So obviously this value E dash will be 271.5 minus 150. So that value will be 121.5 mm. Okay. So this is how we have got the eccentricity of C line above the central axis. So again, here we have to calculate the extreme stresses. So extreme stresses, you can consider this is P, C or P, no problem. So direct stresses P by A minus plus minus. Why we are considering minus plus minus? Because the C line is at top. Okay, eccentricity P is here. Okay, eccentricity of line here. So if you are going to consider the bending, the eccentricity of C line, the pre-stressing force is here. So obviously moment is going to lie like this. And the beam is going to bend at top, okay? And tension will be at bottom, compression will be at top. So that's why we have considered compression at top, tension at bottom. And we have put the value here, C is a pre-stressing force. So after putting the values, we have got this value 4.16, 5.06. And if you are going to add the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber, that value will be 9.22 Newton per meter square and 0.9. And remember, when you are going to analyze the same problem, you will get the same answers in all concept. So see, in stress concept also we have got the same answer, 9.22 at top stresses and bottom stresses. Similar way for strength concept, we have got the same only. And now we are going to see the last concept. So last concept is load balancing concept. So in load balancing concept, you can see first we are going to calculate the value of tan theta. Okay, so tan theta we have considered sin theta, that value we have considered equal to tan theta. So front side divided by adjacent side. So you can see this diagram. So 150 is this. Okay, and we have to consider front side. Then this 150 you have to consider eccentricity. So front side here eccentricity is 150. Front side divided by adjacent side. Beam length is 6 meter. So this is 3000 in mm. So theta if you are going to consider. So front side divided by adjacent side. So 150 by 3000. So 150 by 3000. That value will be 1.20. The inclined tendon will provide an upward force at the mid span. Already we have discussed. We have solved the problem in load balancing concept. Due to this inclination, this tendon will give the upward forces, and those upward forces is going to counteract to this 160 kN force. And this value we have calculated P sin theta. Okay, this is also P sin theta. P sin theta. So total net force which is going to counteract to the external point load will be 2 P sin theta. So here you can see that inclined tendon will provide an upward force at mid span, that this upward force is 2 P sin theta. We have to consider that sin theta's value is very small, so that's why we are going to consider that as a tan theta. So if after putting the values here, 2 into pre-stressing force and that value of tan theta, we are going to get that upward external upward resisting force is 100 kN. So total downward load here 0.4 160, and resistance we are going to get due to the inclination of the tendon is 100 kN. So total net downward load here at mid span is 60 kN. Okay, so here you can see 160 is total external point load. And due to this inclination of tendon, we are getting 100 kN force. So net you can see downward is 160, upward is 100 kN. So net force here downward 60 kN. Okay, and that calculation we have done here. So now next thing we have to calculate the bending moment. So bending moment due to this external point load WL/4 plus due to that self weight of beam. So that WL²/8. So self weight of beam we have calculated 7. So after putting that value here, you will get the bending moment 121.5 kN meter. Okay. And now we have to put that value into the formula P/A plus minus M/Z. And after putting the value via direct stress and bending stress, we are going to get the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber. And those stresses are here 9.22 and -0.9. So here also we have got the same answers at stress at top fiber and bottom fiber. So in three concept, same problem we have seen by using three concept: stress concept, strength concept, and load balancing concept. And in all three we have got the same answer. So whatever the calculation we have done, we can say that calculation we have done is a correct one. Okay. So this how we are you people are going to solve the problems when they are going to ask same problem with using all three concepts. Okay, any problem regarding this?